summer, so I'm putting on some weight. Said I'm getting thick, so I put it on display.
What is wrong here? I make a joke, everybody laughs. I know I'm funny, but I'm not that funny.
Yeah, I just ran a checkup on myself. Some days I just have to check up on myself.
Hey, everybody, it's the coach, and this is Monday Night Football on EA Sports. Straight ahead, we've got a great one on tap between the Seattle Seahawks and the San Francisco 49ers. I'll be back at halftime to look at some of these stats and scores from Sunday's action. But for now, it's Monday Night Football. And to call the action, here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
From the host of Super Bowl 50 back in February of 2016, there's a look at the home of the 49ers, Levi's Stadium in Santa Clara. A few short moments ago, these two teams made their way out of the Levi's Stadium tunnels, and the noise level in this place was deafening. They're set for football as the 49ers get ready to do battle with Russell Wilson and the Seattle Seahawks. With Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all.
First carry for the former Falcon, Tevin Coleman. And a short three-yard pickup gets him up to the 15. A look at the numbers for Coleman in last week's game. 19 carries, 64 yards, and a touchdown.
Yeah, he could very well be on his way to a rushing title, but guess what? His offensive line, they're meeting separately because they want that rushing title as much as he does, and they want to make sure they get him there.
They'll look to throw, and that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
Defensively here, you're facing a top five team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So when they're that high power, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20. Because to me, that's the magic number. 20 points scored, give yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
And I think so, because then you turn it into a shootout. And that means your offense has to keep pace.
First down, it's Coleman. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards, and it's second and two.
54,
on second down, it's Coleman, and he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. 2 yards, good enough for a first. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Now a man who really stepped up last year, this is Matt Breida. And that one goes for about 6 as he's taken down just shy of the 45. Here's Breida. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. 7 yards there and a first down. So from Seahawk territory now, it's first and 10 at the 49-yard line. They run on first down as they get about 3, second and 7 forthcoming. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. On second down, it's Coleman. Now a loose football. Coleman lost it, and the Seahawks have picked it up. And he's able to bring it up 5 yards shy of midfield to the 45-yard line. Often on fumbles, you look at the guy who coughed it up and say, geez, what did he do? But hey, let's tip the cap to the defense here.
Not a problem at all, my man. I'm not even going to tip it. I'm going to doff my cap to him. Congratulations, big time play. Knocking it free and creating something good for your team.
The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And Charles, if the season ended today, and it's not going to, we still have December
Yay,
left.
More football.
We're only in November. But they would be a wild card team. And that's great. They'd be in the playoffs, but you know they're trying to bump up to be one of those division leaders.
That guarantees you at least one home game in the playoffs, and that's what you're really seeking. But there also isn't much margin for error for this team, right? Because right where they're sitting, a two-game losing streak could have them out of the playoffs, so they've got to make sure they continue to keep the momentum going.
Absolutely. There's some sharks smelling blood in the water behind them.
Here we go, D. Here I come again.
A first carry for the converted wideout, J.D. McKissic. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair.
Doubling this guy has to be a priority before moving up to the next level, because the big fella, he just ate that one alive, just stuffed it. In fact, before the game, he was talking to us, and he's like, hey, these pants make me look fat. And we said, nah, man, you're just a whole lot of guy.
He is at well over 300 pounds. He's a big man. On third down, Wilson. And that will be incomplete. And this pass defense, they were sensational in the win last week, and they're looking good here so far in this first quarter.
You know, we often talk about how offenses get locked in, and that runs over multiple games where they're really, you know, in that zone. Defenses can be the exact same way, and I think we're seeing an example of it here.
Now here's Michael Dixon as he's on to punt for Seattle. Oh, and what a play on special teams here. This is going to be down inside the five, all the way down at the two-yard line.
And he's got to be fired up about that effort. I don't think he could have walked down and placed it any better than where he ended up putting the football. That was excellent.
The 49ers offense now, they work their way back onto the field. And it's only November, but the playoffs, we know how it works. They'll be here before you know it. If it ended today, they would be the number one seed.
And that's a great spot to be in, but I love the phrase, if it ended today. And I'll guarantee you, that's what they've discussed in their locker room, in their meeting rooms. Yeah, we know where we'd be if it ended today, but we also know it's not ending today.
Right.
So they've got to continue to play the type of ball that put them in the spot where they're number one in their conference.
Well, they're making an effort to get the ground game going tonight. So far, it's working.
I like what we're seeing from the offensive line. They seem to have the leverage going, and they're controlling things and reestablishing the line of scrimmage, moving that defensive front backwards. But also like what the runner's giving us, too. It appears that he's been waiting all day long to get out here and take off.
And now they have a little more space to maneuver from the 15, first and 10. Right back to Coleman here on first down. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this across the 25-yard line. He'll get a dozen there, and it's a first down, 49ers. Well, one unit I know you want to watch is that offensive line. If they keep clearing holes like that, it could be a long night defensively.
No doubt about it, because when they are in sync, as we're seeing so far, when that continuity is there, and you can see that they're playing off of each other while controlling the defensive front and linebackers, you're exactly right. It could be a very long night for the defense, because someone's going to run for some big yardage.
They'll get 17 on that one, and the Niners have a first down. Kittle last year, what a season. 1,377 receiving yards, an NFL record for tight ends en route to his first Pro Bowl. Not bad for the former fifth-round pick. I remember that game, December against Denver. He had that monster first half, 210 yards, did not have a single catch in the second half, but still those 210 yards were just 4 yards shy of Shannon Sharpe's single-game record for a tight end. They run with Breida, and he's up across midfield and down into Seattle territory. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down. Second and one.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
This will be a 2-yard loss on the play, and that'll bring up a third down. A pass for negative yardage, obviously no good. Maybe he shouldn't have thrown it, or maybe he shouldn't have caught it.
I think we were seeing it at the same time, weren't we? Maybe you let that one go, right? Because you could see the lost yardage about to develop. But that goes against every instinct of a receiver. They're taught to catch everything. So it's really hard to be mad at him and yell at him for trying to make that play.
A battle for it, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the free safety, Eric Berry. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Defensively that time, they were in zone coverage. As a rookie QB, what lesson can you learn there?
Well, understand this. You saw zone in college, and the defensive backs reacted, but they don't react like they do on this level. So when they're in zone and they see the ball coming to them, they'll react at least a half a second faster. You've got to know where you want to go with the ball and be decisive with it. Otherwise, the end result can be something you don't like.
Wilson and the Seahawks take over now, first and 10 at their own 20-yard line. After the interception, here's Wilson. And it's hauled in by Ed Dixon. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. They get 17 on that one. Move the chains. First down, Seahawks. Right after the turnover, they come out throwing.
And that means it's a sudden change situation. We used to practice it on defense. Sudden change, get out there, stop the offense. But you typically run out there a little bit unsettled. I think that's why he came right out throwing the football, hoping to catch him off balance.
And he did. Now a play fake here on first down. He'll find Metcalf. And they've got it well across midfield, down to the 40 before it's all said and done. 23 yards, the final tally.
Not only have they completed a couple on this drive, but they peeled off some pretty good chunks of yardage, too.
Absolutely. Great start. Two nice plays in the pass game. Now can they continue to feed off that? Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Out of the gun, here's Wilson. This one into the hands of Metcalf. And this winds up a pickup of two, maybe two and a half, to about the 39. Give him a couple on the catch, it's second and 8. And just a small glimpse there as to why they like this rookie so much.
And that's why they lit up a little bit in our meetings with the coaching staff, didn't
they? Yeah, when we talked about him, they did.
Yeah, you know, they like his work ethic. You know, this guy's running every route well in the route tree and getting better at it all the time, really honing his game. They expect a pretty good jump out of him as things continue to move on.
So second and 8 here after the pass play for 2 yards on first down. Throwing again here, Wilson. Left side here, taken in by Metcalf. And this will move the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the 49ers' 17-yard line. And boy, they had high praise for this rookie receiver when we asked the coaches about him, didn't they?
They certainly did, and obviously they liked his measurables, otherwise they wouldn't have brought him onto the team. Height, weight, speed, all of that. But how about what they really said? Competitiveness. That's what they really liked about him. The way he goes after the football, competes for it, and decides when it's in the air, it's his and only his.
An inaugural trip to the red zone here for the Seahawks. They've got a first and 10 at the 17. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. It'll be a loss of a yard, and it'll be second and 11.
Perfectly designed blitz right there. They took that one from the grease board to the field because they were able to free up their linebacker to get into the backfield and spill the play.
Maybe just a slight detour on what's been a strong drive. Here's second and 11. Now it's Carson. A nice pickup of 14, and it moves the stick, sets up a first and goal.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember, the last drive, they went 3 and out.
Three. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the four. Only a yard that time. Second and goal. Here's the second-year man from San Diego State, Rashad Penny. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. Call it a loss of two on the play. And that is going to set up third and goal.
His path became similar to almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease, anywhere to put his foot in the ground and cut back. It just never materialized.
So third and goal, and the 49er faithful making some noise for their defense. Now Wilson. And Dixon has it. And the stop will come inside the five at the four. Able to hold him to just 2 yards, and now it's fourth and goal.
He wasn't the primary target, but I think it was almost like a check down situation, wasn't it?
Yeah,
like
hoping he can break some tackles, a big tight end, but he couldn't do it.
Yeah, get it to that big frame and hope he can scatter some bodies, unable to get it done.
On comes the Seahawk kicker here on fourth down. It's Jason Myers from the left hash. Should be a fairly easy one here. Myers' kick is good, and the Seahawks grab a 3-0 lead. So they do get 3 points, but that's now three drives with only the 3 points, not a ratio that's going to win you many ball games.
Not at all, Brandon. And think about it this way. We all know payoff is the key, right? And wouldn't we love to have the concession on every T-shirt that's been printed in football that says finish on it? Because that's the mantra everywhere. Got to be able to finish drives, put points on the board.
And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. Now here's the signal caller getting ready to lead this offense again. He'll look to shake off the interception on the opening drive. He should at least be comforted that it resulted in three, not six.
And if I were him, I would be the guy all the way out on the field greeting my defense now, saying, thanks a lot. You held him to a field goal after I turned it over. That's a big defensive stand for them. He needs to go out now and make up for what he did on the first drive.
The tackle made by K.J. Wright. Second and six, just inside the 30. Coleman now. It's a 6-yard run, leaves him with about a foot or so here still to go to hit the marker with third down coming up. And he went nowhere. Well, he went backwards, back to the 33. That'll back him up 2 yards and also bring up fourth.
If you're a selfish player and you're throwing the ball, you're cool with the completion. Maybe not so cool with the yardage loss, though, huh?
Yeah, you went backwards on the yardage. Hey, it kind of works like a sack for the defense there.
Yeah, it's a really big play for them, right? Able to figure it out, sniff it out, and finish it off.
On is the rookie fourth-rounder Mitch Wishnowsky to punt this one away. Back deep, the former All-Pro Tyler Lockett.
Keep playing.
3-0 after one on EA Sports. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And it's been very much a slow start for them. Three drives and just the 3 points, CD.
Yeah, if you're into the points per drive ratio, that answer is one. And that's not going to get it done in a ball game. They've got to find a way to finish these drives in end zones, not having balls go through goalposts.
Wilson after the play fake to Carson. And oh, he took that in one-handed. What a grab. A first down there on a pickup of 25.
That's an excellent read right there. Saw cover one. That means it's just a single high safety. So you know if you throw the ball to the outside part of the field, help is going to be a little bit late getting there. And he puts one out there for a big-time completion.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Here's Carson. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8.
2 yards on the pickup. It's second down at the 46-yard line.
They'll get 5 on the dump off there, and that'll lead to a third down. The Seahawks on third down, 0 for 3 to this point. They could use a conversion. Here it's 3rd and 3. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield, complete. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. A nice first down pickup on a gain of 6.
As an unbiased observer, I think it would have been interesting to see what they would have done if they hadn't gotten the first down there. But since they did, I guess the point is moot.
Yeah, they're right there in that middle ground, field goal range, punt, go for it. But as you said, they picked it up. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on 1st and 10. Now it's Wilson. That's into the hands of his tight end, Will Dissly. And he's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line. That'll be marked as a 27-yard pickup. Great mix of play calling so far. 3 runs, 3 passes. All 3 passes have been completions. 1st and goal.
I think on defense now, you have to almost take a chance. Rely on your scouting. Pick a play you think they would run here and just load up for it and see what happens.
Watch the crowd.
They'll try and run for it on 1st and goal. And they'll get this from the 8 to the 5. Pickup of 3. And the ball smack dab on the 5-yard line. Here's 2nd and goal. Here's Wilson. Completes it to Dixon. And he gets halfway there from the 6 to the 3 on a gain of 3.
And partner, I think that's a great example that not all tight ends are created equal, because everything was right. Got the completion, but he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though he caught it, couldn't turn it into much more.
They've been denied touchdowns in the red zone twice already. Here comes 3rd and goal. They'll try to run with Carson. And that one going nowhere from the start as he's met in the backfield and goes backwards. Tough sledding. They lose a yard there on 3rd. Let's think here. You're still just in the 2nd quarter. You taking the 3 points?
I am taking the 3 points, and I'm just relying on my defense here. Show me I have a little confidence in them and let the offense know, nice drive. Come back next time. We'll go get 6 then. But for now, we'll take the 3.
And for the 2nd time tonight, this field goal unit comes out here. This will be just a 21-yard attempt. And Myers able to knock it through. And they're able to double their lead in this first half. It's 6-0. No problems in the field goal department so far. He's 2 for 2.
Pretty reliable here in this game, isn't he? And to me, that bodes well for them. If they need him late in the game, his confidence should be sky high.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. Week 10 in the NFL coming to a close tonight. Not too early to look ahead to week 11. We've got Thursday Night Football to get us started. The Dog Pound going to be alive and barking. The first meeting of the year between the Steelers and the Browns. And since the Browns came back to Cleveland, the Steelers are 34-6-1 against their rivals. Browns trying to stem that tide. They begin the drive with Coleman. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. That's going to go as a loss of 1 on 1st down.
We think, Brandon, I like the intensity this defense is showing right here in these first few drives. They're not just holding the line because they're doing their job, but they're doing more than that, aren't they? They're getting a nice push into the offensive backfield.
And a great example right there for the loss on the tackle. After the loss to start out, here's 2nd and 11.
Right here.
2nd and 11. He's got Smith here. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up 3rd down. The Niners on 3rd down. Just 1 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 9. Now a deep ball here. Hauled in just past the 50. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A gain of 26 on the 3rd down conversion. So from Seahawk territory now, it's 1st and 10 at the 48-yard line. On the draw play, Coleman. And he's corralled at the 40, but not before picking up 8. 8 yards the tally on that first down run. Here's second and 2. Here's Coleman. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair.
We all have habits. We can be somewhat predictable, and you know me pretty well on second down and short. What I like to say?
Play action.
Yeah, without a doubt. I thought that was a great spot to call it. Instead, didn't go their way, did it?
No, defense sold out for the run. Worked out well. The Niners on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This is 3rd and 4. They'll set up to throw. They'll set up a screen for Breida. A short gain there of just 4. That'll bring up a 4th down.
He wasn't ready. He wasn't ready.
He dialed up the screen pass on 3rd down. And for a second, it looked like it was all going to come together. And they had a chance to pick up a 1st down. But the defense got there and finished it off.
On 4th down, Kyle Shanahan will send out the field goal unit. This officially a 55-yard attempt. And this kick is not going to be close. It's well short, well right to boot. And this score will stay right where it is. The 55-yard attempt, normally you'd say well within his range. A little surprised he came up short.
And he knew it immediately, didn't he? They are so calibrated, aren't they? They can tell the touch, the feel. When they put the foot to the ball, whether it's going to be good or not, he knew immediately he didn't have that one.
Chris Carson trotting back out there. He's hoping to get it going. They're hoping to get him going, too. You know, he's about ready to pop one here in the second quarter. He's hoping.
And his offensive line teammates, they want to get one of those too because they want to continue to run the football. Most offensive linemen like that part of the game better than pass protection because they're not taking blows, they're actually dealing them out. So what they want to do is show the coaches, hey, if we pop one, we're having success. That way they won't go away from the running game.
They'll be hoping to pop one, break one here this go around. The 2nd down attempt there, knocked down as it leaves the quarterback's hand and it's incomplete. The linebacker, Fred Warner, right there on the coverage. Now it's Wilson.
When you see passes knocked down by those guys I call the frustrated fullbacks, the linebackers, you know that in their zone coverage, they were able to drop, see the ball thrown, and react to it very quickly.
And a good quarterback facing zone coverage, if he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure at the passer.
And into the red zone now. And Charles, they told us offense in the red zone was a focus this week in practice.
A huge priority, and the key was to get points. So you know that all the time during the week they talked about executing, taking care of the football, no big mistakes, make sure they put points on the board and come out of it with that.
So after the run for no gain, here's 2nd and 10. Stepping up, he'll try and run. And able to get him inside the 5 here, just inside the 5 to about the 4. He'll get 9 yards on the keeper there, but it's still going to leave him with a 3rd and 1. Now Wilson.
But if you're going to run the read option, typically, you've got to keep an eye on the defensive end.
And what does that mean? What are you looking for with a defensive end?
Well, you want to play off of what he does. If he collapses inside towards the running back, then you pull it and take it yourself outside in. If he stays outside, you go ahead and leave it with the running back. In this case, pulled it and got good yardage himself.
So he's been a busy man here in this first half. That's 3 field goals for him now.
And not just 3 field goals. but 3 for 3. So even though the offense has struggled a bit putting it in the end zone, they've still been able to come away with points due to his leg.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The 49ers offense now, they get set to head back on the field. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer this time?
Closer.
Yeah, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
Now a give coming right is Breida. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. He's got a rifle one deep left, and that's caught inside the 35. 33 yards that time. For an offense that has not found the end zone yet, that's a big play.
There's the spark right there. The big play that they needed. Now they've got to go ahead and finish this drive and put this ball in the end zone.
So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10, just outside the 30. Looking to throw. Completes it to Coleman. And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. Well, they try to swing it out left into the flat, complete, but really nice open field tackling.
And they played that one like a great boxer. They were on their toes on that one. They weren't back on their heels reacting to the play. No, they saw it, came right for it, and made a nice tackle for lost yardage.
Second and 12 after the first down pass play went backwards for 2 yards. Here we go on second and 12. Completes it to the tight end, Kittle. A pickup of about 3 yards as he's taken down at the 31. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down. He'll drop to throw. Looking to complete it to Pettis, and he's got him. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line.
Now that was well defended, and as a cornerback, what you're taught when you see a wide receiver screen, either you get underneath the play before the blocking forms, or you're going to have to fight your way through it by getting through some blocking. That was a really nice play there.
And for the second time tonight, this field goal unit comes out here. On the left hash, this from 48 yards. And this one looks good. It is good. Right down the pipe. And they are on the board. It's now 9-3. Now, that's something of a pick-me-up, and the offense certainly has struggled, but they do get the field goal before half to put 3 on the board.
Yeah, you don't want to be shut out, but let's face it. Those 3 points, that's not going to solve all their problems either.
This is fielded at the chalk of the 10. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. 1:57 to go in this first half on EA Sports. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 points.
The kicker.
Exactly. You put it through the post, that's going to help him in contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. And the 49ers now going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down. They will run it. It's McKissick. Now San Francisco going to call their second timeout as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Now here's Michael Dixon as the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. And he gets this away, and look at this. This is a good one. And this is going to hit the goal line and continue on into the end zone for a touchback. And San Francisco gets set to go here. It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You can never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
Here's a throw that's taken in out of the backfield. And a great move on the play as he takes this one past the 25. 7 yards on the play, and it'll be a second down. He finds his target. It's Matthews. That catch good for only a yard, and it'll be third down. They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also third down. They'll set up a throw, and it's a fumble, and the Seahawks have picked it up, and his guys will take over at the 30-yard line. Well, he did what he's known for. He made the catch, then he turned into a runner, took the contact, and coughed it up.
And all I remember as a player, when they catch the ball, when those acrobatic guys catch it, you have to make them pay sometimes. You have to put it on them, big tackle, knock the ball free, anything you can do to slow them down.
Well, let's gaze our attention as the offense takes the field on Rashad Penny. He only has a single solo carry, one. Numero uno, second quarter. They need to get in the ball more, don't they?
I'm not the greatest statistician in the world.
Yeah, you are.
But a back like that with only one carry kind of takes me back to college in the classroom. Not enough evidence to declare what you should do the rest of the game. Give him the ball some more and find out.
Will they incorporate him? We'll find out. To throw again on second down. Wilson, it's caught, right side, Dixon. And they'll burn the timeout with 5 seconds left. A chance to try to add 3 points before heading to the locker room. So on third down, the field goal unit will come out as he'll try to get three before half. It's a 39-yard attempt, right hash. Myers' kick is good. And the lead stretches to 9. It's now 12-3. So a late turnover leads to a quick drive, and in turn that quick drive leads to 3 points.
So someone makes a mistake, but how about the other side learning from that mistake, taking care of the ball, and making sure they put some points on the board? Well done.
The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
Meanwhile, they take a shot to start the drive, but this is going to wind up incomplete. So we come upon halftime with 9 points separating these two teams. As we'll send you eastward to Orlando, standing by with that EA Sports Halftime Report now is Jonathan Coachman. Take it away, Coach.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. Welcome in, everyone, to our EA Sports Halftime Report. Let's get you caught up on what's going on around the NFL. We'll get started up at Paul Brown Stadium in Cincinnati, where it was definitely a game with some intrigue, as you can see by the scoreline. Joe Mixon, what a game. 3 touchdown runs in the victory. We'll stay in the AFC South as we head one state over to check on the Indianapolis Colts at home at Lucas Oil Stadium. And it was the visiting Dolphins who were able to get the victory. Ryan Fitzpatrick, terrific in the win, and a much-needed win at that, as it is indeed their first on the year. Finally, let's get out to the Bay Area, see what's happening with the Raiders at home in Oakland. And they were winners in that one over the visiting LA Chargers. 14-7, the final score. In our game has been Russell Wilson, who was dynamic, as usual, in that first half. He's thrown for close to 200 yards already, and that's helped propel his guys into the lead. As we send you back to Brandon Godden.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3.
We play to win. Let's go!
Here comes the 49ers offensive unit, as they'll have it first to begin this third quarter. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. He lost 9 there. That's really going to set him back for second down. Now a quick slant as the throw's complete. It's a 9-yard pickup on the play, and it'll be second and 10. On second down now, it's Coleman. And he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, so that doesn't help. Now they're looking up at a 3rd and 9 situation. They're going to look to throw. And that'll be incomplete. Now they took their shot all right, but it comes up empty, and it's 4th down.
This defense is continuing to contest every deep ball that is thrown downfield. And look, it doesn't matter whether you're playing man or zone. Eventually, that becomes man on man. And you've got to trust yourself and go up at that moment of truth and make a play on the football.
Here comes the 49ers punter now as he'll come on to kick this one away. He gets this away. It's a good one. Drawing toward the sidelines. And this one will not be returnable as it sails out of bounds. So here are the Seahawks ready to take over on offense. They've won 2 straight, and they lead this one as well as they come up on 1st and 10. Wilson and the Seahawks take over now, 1st and 10 at their own 27. They'll start on the ground. It's Rashad Penny. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's 2nd and 9.
Green 80. He's forced out of bounds behind the line of scrimmage.
Mike 54, Green 80.
On 2nd and 9, Wilson. Pressure comes, and Wilson's going to go down. D4 in there to get him, and on the season now, that is 9 sacks for him.
Well, someone's closing in on the league lead in sacks. He came into the game in the top 5. Now you add 2 more to his total.
Wilson of the Seahawks looking for something big following the sack. It's 3rd and long here. From the gun, it's Wilson. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. That winds up being a 4-yard loss and leads to 4th down.
No surprise they decided to throw on 3rd down. A little bit of a surprise that they completed the pass and lost yardage on the play.
Now here's Michael Dixon, standing just outside his own goal line. He steps into this one, and this is a rocket. And this works out well as it'll kick out of bounds at the 11-yard line. Tevin Coleman and the rest of the offense making their way back out. And we have seen a decline in the numbers. Where does the fault lie? Just him? Maybe the guys up front? Combination?
Well, as you and I both know, it's almost always a collective deal. But in this case, I think maybe the offensive line got a little overconfident. They had blocked so well in the first half, picked up on what the defense was doing. I think we've seen an adjustment now that they have not picked up on, and now they're being a little bit overwhelmed.
In on the tackle there, Bobby Wagner coming off a 3rd straight All-Pro season. They stay on the ground. Again, it's Coleman. And able to get it across the 20 before they get to him. A gain of 10 and a 49er first down. Well, CD, a lot of times like to separate speed and quickness, and they've got a back that's both. We know that he's fast in the open field, but man, his first step is so quick, too.
It is something, isn't it? Because you think of that type of speed getting to the perimeter and turning upfield, but also when you run those inside runs, he can get into the secondary so fast, the linebackers don't have a chance to react.
They'll run on 1st down. Coleman. And he loses the football a 2nd time. A call it luck or skill, whatever the case is, they're feeling good about just keeping the football there.
Yeah, the biggest thing that they're calling it now, our ball. I mean, they don't care if it was luck or skill. Boy, the panic that jumps up in your chest when that ball's on the ground. Whether you get it or your teammate gets it, just as long as you maintain possession, that's all you're looking for.
Running out of the gun here, Breida. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. Big play coming up. Here's third and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
The second down play, not much better than the first. Just a gain of one there. And the blitz does come. And some room to maneuver. And he's going to return it to the 21-yard line. Third and long that time. He was trying to make something happen, but a little too risky.
Well, the field tilted on him. And what I mean by that is what you said, third and long. Got to push it downfield to try and pick up the first down. Defensive backs live for this situation, and they took advantage of the young man right there.
The Seattle offense now set to come back out on the field. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete. To throw again on second down, Wilson. And he's got the hook up to Moore. And they'll get this down to the 10. 11 yards there, first down. Penny, the first down carry. And a nice pickup there as he'll take it from the 10 down to the 5-yard line. And they'll run it again with Penny. And he tried to bounce it outside, but they'll stop him behind the line. Officially, it will go as a 1-yard loss, and that's going to lead to a third down.
The short field shrinks even more with the type of bodies they brought in on that play. Those extra tight ends, they weren't able to secure their blocks, and that one ended up going backwards.
What? 49ers have an extra defensive back on the field, a nickel set for third down. From the shotgun, Wilson. And Dixon has it. And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. 2 yards is all they'll get on the completion. It's fourth down.
Well, the strategy was evident there. Get it to your tight end and make it a one-on-one play with a cornerback. Who's usually going to win that one?
The tight end, but not there.
Not in this situation. How about the corner defeating that logic and making a really nice tackle?
Now here's Jason Myers. He gets set for the Seahawk field goal. From the left hash, a chip shot here. And Myers able to knock it through. And that's going to bump up their lead now to 15-3. So yet another field goal to end a drive. That has been a very common theme. He's now hit 5 of them in this game.
Yeah, Brandon, as an offense, you hate that you've had to call on your kicker so often, but you have to love the fact that time and time again, he's come through.
And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Out comes this field general once more, leading his offense back onto the field. And he comes out on the heels of an interception he threw last time they had the ball.
Yeah, and you know, the quarterbacks that I know that are the best ones, the ones that really know how to lead their team, they tell them, that's on me. That's my bad. But let's go back out there and move ahead again, guys. We can get this done.
One good thing for him, it did only lead to 3 points and not a touchdown after that turnover.
Big thanks to the defense.
Here's a 2nd and 7. He finds Matthews. He'll be hit down at the 33, 5 yards on the play. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. They'll try and run for it here. It's Coleman. That is not going to be any help as they dump him behind the line of scrimmage. Continues to be a struggle for this offense and this home crowd. They're growing a little restless here in the second half.
And I think they've just got to look at how they're trying to move the football. Yeah, you want to run it, but maybe you spread it out, maybe some swing passes that can take the place of runs and give you a little more space.
Here comes the 49ers punter now as he's on to kick it away. His first punt, 48 yards. This one looks equally as good. Oh, good move. Great coverage there. Holds him to a 2-yard return following a 50-yard punt. And it'll be Seahawk football, first and 10. The Seahawks offense now, they get ready to head back onto the field. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
A really good pickup of 28 yards. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful? You're losing, playing against a good quarterback like he is, to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz scheme, and you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
Looks like he's going to get a couple here on this first down carry, and that'll make it second and 8. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8. Again, it's Penny. Some extra space following the display of power. Down just inside the 45. Could be four down territory even if they don't get this, but they need just a few inches here on third. It's caught. Lockett. And he got blown up. Losing yardage on the play back at the 44. That'll make it fourth down after a loss of one.
They threw the screen to the perimeter, but to no benefit at all. Tackled behind the line of scrimmage for a loss of yardage.
So on is Jason Myers. He's hit from as long as 58 in his career. And this will be spotted on the other side of the field. It's a 61-yard attempt. And I don't think this has the carry. It does not. It's no good. And this score will stay right where it is. That would have been from way downtown. Pretty big roll of the dice, and he comes up a bit short.
Yeah, you knew when you saw the holder setting up on the other side of the 50 that this was going to be a long shot. But to me, there's really no loss here because you've shown confidence in him. Kicking it from a long distance, that'll pay dividends. And the miss, you can shake that one off. He wasn't likely to make it in the first place.
So they tried the 59-yarder and missed it. And now this offense starts just 1 yard shy of midfield. This is Coleman. And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. It'll go as a first down for San Francisco on a pickup of 16. Good push up front and that run in between the tackles.
Let's play the leverage game here. Offensive line just got lower than the defensive front, and they were able to get their pads on them and move them backwards and create space for their running back to roam.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33.
Oh yeah, I'm coming.
Back to throw here. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Jaron Reed muscles his way in for the sack. A rookie QB struggling, gets thrown down to the ground there. But, you know, maybe this game, it's not over yet, but maybe this game can be a learning experience for him.
So many different things that he has to pick up on. When to go ahead and flush from the pocket and run. When to get rid of the football, not take the sack. When to just go ahead and go down early and make sure you don't fumble the football. So many things that he has to learn. This game starts the process.
He'll look to throw. That's complete to his receiver, Pettis. It's a pickup of 12, and that'll set up a third down. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. He'll look to throw. And able to haul it in is Kittle. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
They really love to get him into one-on-one opportunities, and this is one way. Work him out of the slot and create a mismatch. Who's going to cover him? Corner, safety, linebacker? He's got a way to beat all of those positions.
Might we see our first touchdown of the game? Here's first and goal. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. And it's caught. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1 yard line. Nice gain of 8 that time, and it's second and goal. It's Coleman here. And forget about finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. This will be a loss of 3, and now a much tougher third down looming.
Well, sometimes I get caught in hyperbole, but I think they desperately need to punch this one in. They're running out of time.
Yeah, 2-score game, second half, you're down here. This is the time to put it in the end zone.
And not going to get much better than this for an opportunity.
From back at the 3 now, this is third and goal. They'll drop the throw. And he is going to go down. Back at the 11-yard line. Jaron Reed able to drop him that time for his second sack of the evening.
Third and goal, they decided to throw for it, but how about the play defensively? Couldn't find anyone open, left him nowhere to go with the football, had to absorb the sack.
On fourth down, Kyle Shanahan will send out the field goal unit. And his kick is good. And the lead is down to 9. It's 15-6. They had it first and goal. 3 attempts, couldn't get it in, so they settle for 3.
Yeah, the field tends to shrink a little bit the closer you get to the goal line, doesn't it? It doesn't sound right. It sounds a little counterintuitive. But you run out of space to run the deep routes, so they can just sit on the shorter stuff if you're going to throw it. If you want to run it, there's just not as much space. They end up having to take 3 there.
And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And they've got to be a little bit frustrated about that last drive, missed field goal.
Always hurts a team because, you know, you've put something out there, you've given yourself a chance, you're in range, and the ball doesn't go through the post. But it's not something to panic about, I don't believe. Just keep playing and keep going.
Throwing is Wilson. Completes it to Dixon. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. 11 yards there and a first down for Seattle.
It is hard in zone coverage to stop a curl route because when they see it, they just try and find the open spot and sit down.
Yeah, we always talk about finding the soft spot in the zone. What's the key to doing that? How do you do it?
You have to read what the coverage is. Is it 2 deep? Is it 3 deep? Because then you know where the linebackers are going to drop, what spots on the field they naturally get to, and you find that open space, and then you're in sync with your quarterback. He should be reading the exact same thing, and they put the ball right on you.
10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. One quarter remains here as we wrap up the week on a Monday night. And that'll do it for the end of the second quarter. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. An ideal spot here to get a first down and try to run some more clock. And this is second and less than a yard. Here's Wilson going for Metcalf on the deep ball. And intercepted, maybe the turning point they need. It's the former Seahawk, Richard Sherman. And the return will stop right around the 25.
Oh, and that's a nice job defensively to get a piece of the football. He's going to pop it into the air, and then it's the tip drill. And good concentration by him to react to it and pull in the interception.
The San Francisco offense getting their last-minute instructions before they take over here. And last time, able to get 3. It's not what they wanted. They wanted 6, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. Just I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker try.
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Cassius Marsh, credit him with a sack as he buries him for a loss of 10. Defensively, you said coming in earlier in the broadcast, the magic number was 20 points for you. That's what you thought they would have to hold this offense to or less than that. And wow, they've done that in a big way, haven't they?
Not only have they done it, they put themselves in a great position to win this one because holding them down was paramount. If they could get it done, Well, guess what? We see the end result. Right now, they have their eye on victory.
And leading here in the fourth. And the job becomes twice as difficult now after the sack. It's second and 20. Back to throw. This one into the hands of Kittle, the tight end. And able to get it here to about the 16-yard line. That catch good for only a yard, and it'll be third down.